This is Pro Wrestling USA, the program that provides you with the very best in professional wrestling, featuring stars of both the AWA, the American Wrestling Association, and the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance. Now, here's the host of Pro Wrestling USA, Ken Resnick.
All right, hello again, ladies and gentlemen. Ken Resnick with you right here on Pro Wrestling USA tonight, live from the Winnipeg Arena. And ladies and gentlemen, you can hear by that music, you heard the bombshell of an announcement last week. The one and only Sergeant Slaughter. Sergeant, welcome again to Pro Wrestling USA.
Well, it's great to be back with all the wrestling fans. It's great to be back on the East Coast. It's great to be associated with Pro Wrestling USA, the number one wrestling association in the entire world today.
Sergeant Slaughter, a tremendous card in store for the fans today. The likes of Nick Bockwinkel, the Fabulous Ones, Dino Bravo, the great Bob Backlund, and then that tag team main event, Kurt Hennig and Steve Olsonowski to face the masked superstar and Mr. Saito.
You just explained it all. All the top wrestlers are right here on Pro Wrestling USA. Bockwinkel, I've heard a lot about you, boy. If you want to mess around with me, if you want to mess around with the Slaughter Cannon and the Cobra Clutch, world known, I'll be happy to oblige you.
All right, wrestling fans, Nick Bockwinkel trying to agitate the one and only Sergeant Slaughter. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Today's first match.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we go with top-notch professional wrestling. In our first bout tonight, introducing in the corner to my right, from Phoenix, Arizona, weighing 240 pounds, Tom Zank. And in the corner to my left, from Beverly Hills, California, weighing 248 pounds, he is the former heavyweight champion of the world, Nick Bockwinkel. Your referee is Eddie Sharkey. Now down to Vern Gagne.
Thank you, Doug McLeod. Here we go. With the first bout. Former AWA champion Nick Bockwinkel against young and upcoming Tom Zank. Doug McLeod.
Zank, one of the rising stars in professional wrestling today, Vern Gagne, no question about it. And Bockwinkel, oh so wise and experienced in the ways of winning on the big time circuit.
We saw him back off the ropes there, which is a little bit unusual for him, but watch out, Tom, don't fall for that one. Nice sit out, turn, reverse, switch.
Take down now by the former champ Bockwinkel, but look at that head scissors, quickly in and quickly out comes Nick Bockwinkel. So, no surprises in the early going. A big match for Tom Zink. And they break on the ropes, referee Eddie Sharkey. Now Nick Bockwinkel very much has his eyes on that heavyweight belt worn by Rick Martel, the AWA, Ric Flair in the NWA.
Well, either belt. That's that one in the ropes. Young Zink had to be watching for. Got careless and going to pay the price.
Here into the turnbuckle with a hard slam by Bockwinkel. Grabbing the hair, in goes Zink again. Now the arm drag one side, the hair grab the other side, and over the second rope and down onto the cement floor. Oh, and it's hard under here, too. You get thrown through those ropes onto this floor, and you feel it for a few days. Slaps and Zink back down to the deck again. Nick Bockwinkel facing the ring. Good. Foot right to the midsection, and Zink can't get back in.
He's got to move around, Doug. He's got to move around. He's got to get his bearings about him, his wits about him, and he's taking a foul. You hear that way over here.
Our outstanding crew with our ringside microphones, you can really pick it up. Brother, I'll tell you, when Bockwinkel plants one on you, there's a foot to the shoulder of Tom Zink. Slams him into the canvas, and he's used just about every part of the ring now on Tom Zink.
Tom has got to move around the ring out there. He's coming up that same spot every time. He should move around the ring. He's got 10 counts to get back in. But Bachman will pull him through the ropes and keeps on hammering him. A reversal. Oh,
he got out of it. Look at this. Down goes Bockwinkel, and Zink, keeping his wits about him. Flying drop kick by Zink. Bockwinkel on the ropes. Zink attacks immediately. Can't give Bockwinkel any time. Down he goes. Count of one, two. But out of it comes, for many years, heavyweight champion Nick Bockwinkel. Oh, and he missed the flying drop kick as Bockwinkel came off the ropes and just hit the brakes. He gets Zink now. Look at this. Oh, right down with it. Throw it on the lower rope. And another one with a knee drop to the shoulders.
Bockwinkel being the veteran. Oh, watch this. Going for the pile driver.
Here's the pile driver. Oh, down it went. Over for the cover. One, two, and that's it. Nick Bockwinkel. Oh, brother. Finished it off with a pile driver in big style.
Well, certainly shooting for that heavyweight belt worn by Rick Martel and Ric Flair. Everyone.
Here it comes. That patented pile driver. Oh. Bockwinkel puts it on, and the lights go out on Zink.
Again, wrestling fans, I do want to remind you that tremendous pre-Meadowlands Pro Wrestling USA Tour, Wednesday, January 23rd, Ridgewood Grove Arena in Queens, Thursday, January 24th, at Ice World in Totowa, New Jersey. The main event already signed, the Road Warriors to defend the Tag Team Championship of the World against the Fabulous Ones. Friday, January 25th, the State University of New York at Old Westbury. Six-man tag team action, the Road Warriors and Precious Paul Ellering to meet the Fabulous Ones and their mystery third man. Now, Sheikh Adnan LKC, I see you've got with you your hired assassin, if you will, Mr. Saito. Tremendous amount of controversy after what your entourage did injuring Jim Brunzell here on Pro Wrestling USA some weeks ago.
You know, Mr. Conradnik, we keep on injuring people who stepped in the ring with my man, Mr. Saito, and his partner, because we are not afraid of anybody. If any combination, if any tag team in the world today, no matter what place and no matter what town we go in, I got my man, Mr. Saito, and his partner. You know what happened to Jim Brunzell?
I saw that, and she got that out, Casey.
Yes, they carried him out, didn't they?
I have a very hard time believing even you are proud of actions
yes,
like
I
that.
Yes, I am very proud of it, and we're going to do it over and over again. And Mr. Saito, tell him.
I like you, Mr.
Yes,
Sheik.
Hey.
You are rich man.
Hey.
I love Arab people.
Yes.
You got a lot of gold,
yes,
lot of oil.
Yes.
Sheik, I tell you something.
Yes.
You say everything you tell me, everything I do.
Yeah, you that?
If you,
yes.
You destroy ya, I destroy ya.
Yes.
You say torture, I torture.
Yes.
You say kill, I kill.
Yes.
Because you have a lot of money.
Thank you.
Mr. Saito, a lot of money.
Well, yes, wrestling fans, obviously, Mr. Saito certainly has been swayed by the vast wealth of Sheikh Adnan LKC. Stay with us. We'll be right back right here on Pro Wrestling USA.
Wrestling fans, Wednesday night, January 23rd, Ridgewood Grove Arena, Ridgewood, Queens, New York. You will see the Fabulous Ones, the Sheik, the Road Warriors will be there. Former WWF champion Bob Backlund, the masked superstar, and the sensational, the one, the only, Sergeant Slaughter. The action begins at 8 o'clock. Plenty of good seats available, but do not be disappointed. Get your tickets now.
First of all, in the corner to my right, weighing 220 pounds from Shediac, Nova Scotia, Brian Jewell. Jewell, his tag team partner, weighing 270 pounds from Cleveland, Ohio, Scott Doring. Doring. And in the corner to my left, here they are, with a combined weight of 467 pounds from Delray Beach, Florida, Stan and Steve, the Fabulous Ones. Your referee, Joe Fiorino. Now down to Vern Gagne.
Well, this ought to be a tremendously interesting match. The fabulous ones. We certainly know about two great young stars in wrestling today. And look at this one. Reminds me of a Mr. America, Arnold Schwarzenegger or something.
Look at the upper
look
end of that guy.
275 pounds.
That is Scott Doring from Cleveland. There's a look. He just immediately throws Stan Lane over into the ropes. I think Stan is going to think about this for a minute. Maybe just a tie-up in the center of the ring is not the best idea with a guy built like Scott Doring. Here's Steve Kern hanging on the ropes watching as his tag team partner gets sent back to the turnbuckle again by Scott Doring. Doring just stands there and paces and looks. There's a flying takedown of the arm by Stan. He gets a look at him. Put the paint on, pull that arm, twist it back to the corner, and there's the tag, and in comes Steve. Going to work on that left arm of Scott Doring. Over on the side of the ring. Pressure points, so many of them, grabbing that wrist, thumb, but look at this. Doring right out of it, and a body slam right there.
Look at the power of that Doring, tremendously strong. His arm was extended, a lot of leverage and pressure being put in his arm, but he scooped right in there with one arm, picked up Steve Kern, slammed him to the mat. So, something to be reckoned. Look at the legs on him, big calves, boy. Big thighs.
Yeah, I guess he pumps a little iron, folks. They lock it up in the center of the ring, and now Doring gets that side headlock onto Kern. And try to get out of it, muscle it up. Grabs the hair for a moment, but yeah, I guess referee Joe Fiorino did see it. Warning Scott Doring now, who protests his innocence. And still, he works on the side of the head. Steve Kern trying to power his way back up again and turn this around the other way. The tremendous arm strength of Scott Doring makes it mighty hard, though.
Well, Doug, from over here, it looks like when the arm wrist lock was being applied by Steve Kern, Doring got a handful of hair. Pull it back into it.
And on the tag, Kern gets out of it. So now in comes Brian Jewell, a young man from Shediac, Nova Scotia. They'll see, and he goes immediately to the same hold again.
Well, that's the way to do it. Keep grinding away. Keep wearing him down in those same holes if you can possibly get them.
But now Steve throws it off the ropes. Brian knocks him down. Look at this. Huh? There goes Brian Jewell. Came down hard. The lower part of that back, the small of that back, the back of the rib cage.
Beautiful hip lock by Steve Kern.
Takes him down. There's the tag. Here's Stan Lane and Jewell at his mercy. And now the fans go away.
The wishbone, Doug.
On the way out of the tag. Up and over for the pin. Let's see if Joe Fiorino saves it. Not time.
Here's a tough toe hold. It doesn't look like a whole lot of pressure here, but it's really now one of the more painful holds in wrestling, that toe hold that Stan Lane here just applied.
Now he steps over, turns it the other way, down, and look at the way he can immediately leverage those shoulders of Brian Jewell down, and here's the tag again.
They work very well together. They're just in the right spot to reach over and make that tag.
Here are two guys. You don't see them. Now look at this, on the bottom of the ropes. Ooh, right on that inner thigh of Brian Jewell. They work only as a tag team. They don't wrestle individually. All their time, their hours, spent perfecting this tag team machine, if you want to call it that, of the fabulous ones. Tag in the corner, Jewell to the roof. Steve Kern just plowed it.
Tremendous elbow, Doug.
Oh, Jewell is out of it now. Look at this, just hanging on to Jewell. The slam, they already got the tag off. Here's Stan Lane. Looked like a little judo move. Now up and over. Down goes Jewell. Here's the count to two. And three.
To me like a little bit off the mat there, but I guess the referee closer than I saw that the muscle in the back went down. Three count, there it is.
There he is.
Fabulous wins again.
And fabulous they are, and what a team they are. Here's the replay. You watch as they go to work. Now, here's Stan Lane up with that leg. Joe Fiorino counting it off, checking the shoulders. And that's it. Out goes Brian Jewell, and the Babs chalk up another one. victorious here.
Ladies and gentlemen, with me, the fabulous ones. Gentlemen, congratulations. Very, very impressive win. But, Steve, you've got to be happy. Thursday, January 24th at long last in Totowa, New Jersey. You've got the shot, the Road Warriors, and the Tag Team Championship of the World.
You know, I don't know how things are in New Jersey, but they're getting ready to explode. You know, we've been in the top 10 in the nation for over 3 years. It's always just that one little step right under the Road Warriors. Well, I'll tell you something, New Jersey people. When we come to fight in your town, we're going to come to fight to win. We ain't coming to New Jersey to mess around. Because when you get in the ring with the Road Warriors, you don't mess around. You got to go for the gold. I'll tell you something, Precious Paul. You polish them belts up real good. Because you ain't seen the fabs take a back step yet. And we're not about to. We're going to keep coming until we get them.
You know something, Ken? They're big guys. They got the big arms. They put their all on and they look really good. Let me tell you something, guys. This ain't no powerlifting contest. It's not a bodybuilding Mr. Universe contest. This is wrestling. That's exactly what we're coming to do, brother. Shine the belts up and kiss them goodbye.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Fabulous Ones. Remember, as part of that tremendous pre-Meadowlands tour in Totowa, New Jersey, Thursday, January 24th, the Fabulous Ones will meet Punches Paul Ellering, Animal and Hawk, the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, at stake the Tag Team Championship of the World. Now, stay with us. We'll be right back with you with more of the greatest wrestling in all the world right here at Pro Wrestling USA. Still to come, the Canadian great Dino Bravo, the likes of the tag team of Kurt Hennig and Steve Olsonowski, all right here on Pro Wrestling USA. We'll be right back.
Here on Pro Wrestling USA, introducing now, in the corner to my left, from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 231 pounds, Drew Tozel. Tozel. And in the corner to my right, from Montreal, Quebec, weighing 248 pounds, Dino Bravo. Bravo. The referee is Eddie Sharkey. Now down to Vern Gagne.
Well, there we go. Dino Bravo, one of Canada's greatest present-day wrestlers and maybe all-time wrestlers out of Montreal, Canada. Tremendously strong. A bench presser in the 600-pound range,
oh,
Doug.
Brother. That is tremendously strong. They lock up in the center of the ring, and Bravo attacks first. Down goes Drew Tozel. Working that submission hold right in the early part of the match.
If you notice those headlocks by those stronger people a little while ago, we saw Dorn out here, tremendous arms and body, but going for that headlock, they got tremendous strength in those arms, and that's where they start to work on the head.
Now they break on the ropes, and Dino Bravo and Drew Tozel will square off again. Tozel circling Bravo, waiting. In they go. Center ring tie-up again, off to the corner. Oh, and a slap right to the throat. Boy, he got him right on the throat, too. Bravo moves back, and there's another slap by Tozel. Tozel working on Dino Bravo over in the corner. There's a good shot of it. Oh, but Bravo comes racing right back again. You could hear that one. That didn't need any explanation.
It sure didn't.
Oh, brother, Tozel to the ropes. Got picked by Dino Bravo. He caught Tozel hard in the, looked like the left shoulder on that one. Now he tries to pull him back. Oh, power slam down. And
now, suplex, beautiful.
Two, and just almost got it. That was it.
Was that it?
That was it.
Here we go.
I guess that
Dino
was
Bravo. Good. Quick bang.
Oh, brother. Dino Bravo went right to work. Tozel, and no question about it, that suplex to suplex can really put out the lights, can it, Vern? We'll see it.
It certainly did. Look at this. It's a back suplex by Dino Bravo. Just beautiful. And there he is with the count. One, two. Boy, that shoulder was close. It was close. But the referee, again, he's in there closer than we are, Doug. That three count came. It was over. Dino Bravo, the winner.
There he is. Hand up, stretched in the air. We head down to ringside now, and our broadcast partner, Ken Resnick, standing by.
All right, thank you very much, Doug. With me, of course, Dino Bravo. Dino, I'll give you a second to catch your breath. Very, very impressive win. But ladies and gentlemen, with me, as you can see, the AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Rick Martel. Rick, again, tremendous amount of conversation about the match right here on Pro Wrestling USA. You had a couple of weeks back with one gorgeous Jimmy Garvin.
There's no doubt there was a lot of controversy about it. And I'm asking right now all the promoters, the AWA Championship Committee, to get me a rematch against this man, Garvin, because I want to start 1985 on the right foot, and I want to clear this thing once and for all. This man's trying to destroy what it took me 11 years to accomplish. I'm not going to let him. I'm going to get away with it. I'm going to get even with this man. You know, I know if the fans were in my shoes, they'd do the same thing to get back at him. And I'm asking the promoters to get a rematch against Jimmy Garvin.
Now, Rick, you've been on record as demanding him again, but a lot of promoters feel you're making a mistake. You fell into Garvin's trap once. We all saw exactly what he's capable of right here on Pro Wrestling USA. You could be opening a Pandora's box by asking for him back in the ring.
Yeah, but you know, Ken, I can't go on defend my title, go and travel all around the world knowing this man is on my trail. I have to get him off my back, and I want a rematch, and I'm going to sell this thing once and for all. Thank you.
All right, Rick Martel, heavyweight champion of the world, Dino Bravo. Dino, great to have you back here on Pro Wrestling USA on the East Coast. Dino, you've been very, very active since the last time we've seen you.
Exactly, but this is the greatest happening in professional wrestling, in the history of professional wrestling, the fact that the NWA, the American Wrestling Association, merged together to get the best of talent in the wrestling world today and go out in the East Coast and have those performances. But my goal, I haven't been in the East Coast in quite a while. I've been in Canada for the last 5 years. I was the number one contender to this title for over a year, and number one contender to the NWA title. So my purpose is not satisfied yet. I am challenging today Martel for his belt, especially Ric Flair, the NWA champion. So people of the East Coast, satisfy your curiosity. Go out and see the best wrestling in the world at the Meadowlands and everywhere in the East Coast.
All right, Dino Bravo, Rick Martel, two very, very close friends. But Rick, very quickly, how could you prepare for a match with a close friend like Dino Bravo?
Well, Dino, I know he's a tough man. We work out in the gym a lot, you know, and the best way to prepare for a match like that, you better get in the best shape of your life.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, two great champions, Rick Martel, Dino Bravo. Stay with us. Coming up next, right here on Pro Wrestling USA, the great Bob Backlund. We'll be right back.
Stops here on Pro Wrestling USA, and here we go. Introducing now, in the corner to my right, weighing 258 pounds from Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan, Rick Renslow. Renslow. And in the corner to my left, weighing 232 pounds from Princeton, Minnesota, people still like to call him the champ. He is Bob Backlund. Backlund. Your referee, Joe Fiorino.
Here we go. Bob Backlund, of course, one of the all-time greats. I don't know where he's going outside the ring handing his robe. Some young man or some young lady out there. And here he goes, the great Bob Backlund.
Boy, he is a dandy, too. A very wholesome, clean-cut fellow who really makes the business of professional wrestling and the sport of being a professional athlete and the wrestling just seems so fun because he has fans wherever he goes. He runs youth camps. He's just a tremendous individual, and he gets a quick one in on to Rick Renslow, who spots him a good 20-some pounds. But I'll tell you, Backlund.
Well, I've had the pleasure, Doug, of working out with Bob Backlund, and one of the finest conditioned athletes I've ever come up against, and technically one of the great, great wrestlers of all time, and I want to give him his credit.
I tell you, it's
and
always
his dues.
That's right, and he's a great pleasure to watch wrestle, too, as
pushing around here into a wrist lock, coming out of that headlock. Bob has got a lot of different moves into a hammerlock. One of Bob's favorite moves, of course, is that chicken wing with that crossface.
We'll see it, I expect, before too long.
Well, he'll try for it, that's for
sure. He'll try it, yeah.
Renslow certainly knows that he uses that hold. We'll be watching for it.
Backlund now working Renslow. Renslow finally gets himself draped over the ropes and is able to pull that left arm free. Hammerlock of Bob Backlund. Look at Backlund. Just all business, all work. Right at him. Look at this. Look at this. Renslow trying to kick that leg out from under Bob Backlund.
Well, Renzel will get tired before Bob Backlund does, I know that. He could bounce there all day. Oh, beautiful. Oh,
did he get out of that one? There is a great, great wrestler, ladies and gentlemen. You are watching one of the all-time great names in professional wrestling, and you are seeing why that is so. Bob Backlund, in a screen to your right. There you see him.
That's why millions of people still call him the champ. Because they have a great, great respect, everyone does, the wrestlers included, of this man's ability.
Now turnabout fair play, and Backlund just picks up. Now down goes Rick Renslow. Caught him from behind, and Renslow hurt the small of the back.
Renslow not being able to jump over the foot of Bob Backlund.
Nowhere near the agility of Bob Backlund in that respect. Renslow getting on the fans, and the fans on Renslow, and Bob Backlund waits in the center of the ring.
Well, another capacity crowd here tonight, Doug, to watch these great, great wrestlers, these great performers. Big headlock by Bob Backlund. Look at the back on this young man. The legs.
Brother, that's muscle, folks. All the way up and down. You see him alternately apply even more pressure in that headlock.
He's grinding that forearm across the jawbone of Renslow. And you maybe can't see it here, but Renslow is in tremendous pain at the moment.
I'll tell you, I've had it done to me just for demonstration purposes, and it hurt. Now, off the ropes. Look at this, Backlund, over goes Renslow, and all of a sudden Renslow, who has been in trouble at the hands of Bob Backlund already in this match, is in serious trouble.
Great reversal there, Doug. Renslow tried to hip lock Backlund. Backlund reversed it, applied the hip lock to him, and set him down not too gently.
Whoa, there was a job of work getting Renslow over. He's got that big right shoulder up off the canvas, and now reverses it back onto Backlund, but in the time it takes to say so, Bob Backlund is back on top. Backlund and Rick Renslow. And still, Backlund keeps up the pressure. Working on the side of the head, the shoulder. Whoa. Now he's going to try it. Look at that. Over goes 260 pounds of Rick Renslow.
Tremendous power there in Bob Backlund. I guess as a former wrestler, you can appreciate some of these power moves that he makes. Maybe more so than the person who's ever wrestled. It's a great tribute. He did. Bob Backlund this summer worked out with our U.S. Olympic Greco-Roman wrestling team. And again, I think helped our boys garner three or four medals there in the Olympics.
That great Olympic team, which Brad Rangins was such an instrumental part. There's a big head butt into the middle of Bob Backlund by Rick Renslow. He's got Backlund on the ropes, and you see referee Joe Fiorino now just physically trying to drag Renslow off him. But look at this now. Back on with a choke. For a moment, anyway.
He's about driving him through the ropes, Doug. Backlund better hang on. Get out of that position. That's a long, mean drop to the floor from that, but from there.
Renslow now having his opportunity against Bob Backlund. A little bit with the fingernails right down the front. Ooh. Started on the side of the head all the way down the front. But look at this. Backlund turns him back. Up and over. Down goes Renslow. And now.
Watch this. Watch this. Oh, a tremendous kick.
Woo. Drop kick by Backlund. Sends Renslow. Look at Backlund. Springing. Pouncing. Down goes Renslow.
Tremendous drop kicks, Doug. Oh. He really put a. Watch this. Double arm suplex attempt, and he gets it.
Oh, he got it. He got it. Over for the cover. There's the one. There's the two count. That's it. What a tremendous move as Backlund, in his convincing awareness, convincing a demonstration of power and conditioning, not to mention wrestling sense, Vern Gagne, as you never want to see.
Well, Bob Backlund had taken some time off here, but watch this. Here we go. Double arm suplex back. Look at the power.
Oh.
What, Renslow coming down with his 275 pounds onto his back, and there she is. Crotch and half Nelson by Bob Backlund, and the winner, Bobby Backlund.
And Bob Backlund says thank you to the crowd here.
All right, now, fans, before we talk to Bob Backlund, Jim Brunzell, a couple of weeks ago, all the fans saw you injured at the hands of the Masked Superstar. You've got some big matches coming up out here, Queens, Westbury. How, Totowa, how is the neck?
Well, I finally got the okay. I was wearing a neck brace off and on to keep my neck in traction. The masked superstar, being paid by Adnan El-Casey, once again showed his true colors, tried to blindside me, tried to hurt me, tried to get me out of wrestling. Well, masked superstar and Adnan El-Casey, I've got a lot of catching up to do. And we're going to do it together, aren't we, Greg?
You better believe it. You know, I've been on the shelf for 7 months and just came back to wrestling not too long ago. And as soon as we get back, once again, Sheikh Adnan El-Casey hires a man, mass superstar, Mr. Saito, and tries to eliminate my partner after I've been on the shelf for 7 months at the hands of Sheikh Adnan El-Casey. Like Jim said, we got some catching up to do. Mass superstar, Saito, Sheik, we're coming for you, and Road Warriors, we're coming for that title.
All right, now, Bob Backlund. Bob, come on in. Very impressive match. Great to have you here.
It's great to be here. Great to be here, and it's great to get back into this area. You know, I was told that the people of New York City don't care about people that have pride, that people want to have high morals. I was told that the people of the East Coast didn't care about anything about that. Well, I've got high standards, and I got high morals, and we're coming into New York City. We're coming into Queens. Ridgewood Grove Arena, Tottawa, New Jersey, Westbury, Long Island. And I'm going to be there and I'm going to fight. I've got a lot to prove. I'm climbing up the top of Pro Wrestling USA. I don't want nothing turned over to me on no silver platter. Boy, this is exciting for me because you people are my friends. And we're very close. And I've been kept out of your arenas. I've been kept out of your living rooms for a long, long time. And I got goose pimples all over my body to hear your cheers, to hear your support. I want to thank you, too, for all those great, great letters.
All right, fans, really many of you still consider him to be the champion. We'll be right back.
Professional wrestling at its finest on Pro Wrestling USA with another tremendous tag team bout, and here we go. Introducing, first of all, in the corner to my right, weighing 234 pounds from Edina, Minnesota, Steve Olsonoski. Olsonoski. His tag team partner from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 235 pounds, part of the Axe Attack, he is Kurt Hennig. Hennig! And in the corner to my left, accompanied by the man from Baghdad, Iraq, Sheikh Adnan El-Casey, in their corner and ever dangerous, weighing 249 pounds from Tokyo, Japan, Mr. Torture, Mr. Saito. Saito. And from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 285 pounds, the Masked Superstar. The Masked Superstar. Your referee, Eddie Sharkey. And now down to Jack Lanza.
Thank you, Doug. I look for this to be an excellent wrestling match. Mr. Saito, Mr. Torture, very good wrestler. I know the masked superstar. I've seen him a number of times across the country. He's big, strong, and he can wrestle. And you got two young lions right here, Hennig and Olsonowski.
You bet. That's a fine young tag team. I think this is a great tag team. Masked superstar and Mr. Saito. Between them, you've got most of the wrestling holds ever invented, a lot of the work. To work
nice
on
take
you.
Down right there on Steve Ol.
That's right. The masked superstar going to work first on Steve Olsonowski. There are a couple of guys instantly recognizable. The masked superstar, Mr. Saito. And now, Olsonowski in trouble early, but up he comes. Back into the rope. Oh, a tremendous down to the deck from the masked superstar. Did he tag off? I guess he did. Saito comes in. And Mr. Saito, chops to the throat. A knee out of the corner by Olsonowski.
He's fighting him back, but
fingernails.
No,
Olsonowski was trying to get to his corner to Kurt Hennig, but Saito said no way and throws him through the air and slams into the mat. Now out of the corner. Olsonowski. And there's the tag. There's a good move. Now both Hennig and Olsonowski on Mr. Saito. He got an elbow on both sides. And Hennig, look at this. Slamming away, pounding away, covering Mr. Saito now.
barely got a two count out.
I don't think Saito and Mass Superstars expect anything like this.
She capped on LKC over in the corner, threatening Steve Olsonowski, who takes after him right above us. Meanwhile, Saito has turned the tables on Kurt Hennig. Look at the leg outstretched, the boot ready for the Masked Superstar.
And they don't have to do this. Saito's got more wrestling moves, in fact, than any wrestler I've ever seen. All devastating wrestling holds, but he resorts to everything he can.
And if wrestling doesn't do it, he's got judo, he's got karate. You name a martial art, he's probably got a black belt in
it. He knows how to break every rule in a wrestling book.
Kurt Hennig out of it on a one count. Off the
rope, right in the throat.
Right in the throat at full steam as Kurt Hennig went down to the deck. There's the tag, and in comes Mr. Saito. The Masked Superstar holding on. Hennig just couldn't keep his balance, no question about it. Oh, one of those great Japanese moves now turned around by Saito.
Mr. Saito's finishing hold. He's finished many a wrestler with this.
Working now on Kurt Hennig. Olsonowski poised to come in. Will he? Here he comes. Olsonowski over the rope. Lands into Saito, who comes down actually on top of referee Eddie Sharkey. So that gives a momentary reprieve, but only momentary to Kurt Hennig. Kurt Hennig and the Masked Superstar. It's really three against two because you know the Sheik will do any kind of damage or dirty work he possibly can given the opportunity.
I tell you, Kurt Hennig is tough, but he's taken an awful lot of punishment from the Masked Superstar and Mr. Saito, Mr. Torture.
Now Eddie Sharkey asking Kurt Hennig, will you submit? What do you say? Superstar now, Olsonowski turns on the Sheik as he, you can see him on the right side of your picture there, the Sheik cruising around looking for any opportunity to cause trouble.
Drop toe hold by the Masked Superstar. Here comes Saito.
Saito, well, thought he was going to bounce off the ropes. He decided not to.
Well, they made the tag. The Masked Superstar to hold Kurt Hennig down. They don't want to let him get to the corner, make that tag.
That's right. Go back and forth from the neutral rope. Hennig just slaps away, sort of flailing away at Saito, and now Saito, ooh, there were the fingers and the fingernails right in the eyes, but Hennig gets the tag. Here comes Olsonowski, rested and ready to go, attacking Saito, off the rope, flying dropkick, and down goes Saito. Here it is again, and the first, oh! The crowd doesn't drive it into you, nothing will. He's going to try it once more. Takes him over backwards. Down for the cover goes Olsonowski.
Suplex didn't phase him.
Tried it from the reverse side, but over in the corner, getting dangerously close to the corner. Now everybody's in. Olsonowski and Saito.
Look at the Sheik. The Sheik jumped up on the apron.
Now the Sheik. Oh, Olsonowski.
He's hammering the Sheik.
Look at that. The Sheik.
Saito
and salt or sand out of the trunks. Probably salt. Ceremonial salt.
Karate in the throat. Karate.
Oh, and Olsonowski, his eyes full of salt. A chop to the throat, and that's all. Oh, and Olsonowski. Pin the referee, Eddie Sharkey. Was distracted. A handful of salt to the face. And Hennig is
out of the rope.
Here comes Olsonowski. Minute. What are they going to do? He can't even see.
Oh.
Full time in the center of the ring.
280 pounds across the throat. Saito's up on top of the rope.
Trying to stop the match. Referee Eddie Sharkey.
Here comes the stars.
Here's Sergeant Slaughter. Oh, and Sergeant Slaughter out of nowhere on the attack. There goes the Masked Superstar. Now, there goes Saito off the rope. Sergeant the Sheik now. Uh-oh. Look out. Look out. Here goes the combat belt. The Sergeant
no
is
way.
Getting ready. The Sheik running for his life now, as fast as he can get back to Iraq.
I saw the Sarge standing back there. He's not going to stand back there and see anything like this happen. He took as long as much as he could.
The incredible Sergeant Slaughter, after Olsonowski had salt thrown in his face. We'll see how much of this we can see. Now, here's the look right out of the trunks. Hands
right
full of
in
it.
His face.
Oh, that was certainly blatant. Look at that. hand back in to dump the rest of it back in the concealed pocket in his trunks, and Olszanowski is blinded by now. He doesn't have a clue. There's the pin, but oh, and Sergeant Slaughter comes in to do a little revenge at the end. Brother, Saito and the Superstar, and of course, always there, the Sheik.
All right, wrestling fans, it's little wonder that Sergeant Slaughter, indeed, Inspirational Wrestler of the Year. Sarge, my compliments to you. Unable to stand back and watch the Sheik once again double, triple teaming up to his old dirty tricks.
That's one reason I became the Inspirational Wrestler in 1984. Because of these fellows like the Sheik, Saito, and the Masked Superstar. Fellows, you have not seen the last of Sergeant Slaughter. When I am out to do something, when I declare war on someone, there are a lot of battles. I might win some, I might lose some, but let me tell you something. Right here and now, Sheik, Masked Superstar Saito, I want one of you right here, right next week. And I'm not leaving this station. There's nobody leaving this arena until I give word that I'm going to wrestle Saito right in this ring next week. This TV station will not go off the air. I will not let anybody leave this building, including you.
All right, Sergeant Slaughter, you came to Pro Wrestling USA a week ago. Tremendous bombshell. Your actions here, commendable to say the least.
I gave my heart to America. I gave my blood, sweat, and tears to wrestling fans. And let me tell you, if it's the last thing I do, if it's the last breath of air out of my body, I'm cleaning up. I'm cleaning up, you Sheik. I'm cleaning you and your henchmen, and we're going to take you and make you leave this country. We don't need people like you around here. Like I said, when Sergeant Slaughter says he's going to do something, you can take it to the bank. And again, I'm not leaving right now to get somebody out here. I'm not leaving this TV station. I'm not leaving this arena. And nobody here is leaving until I get confirmed word that I get Saito in that ring right here next week.
All right, now, Sergeant Slaughter, wrestling fans all up and down the East Coast know what you did to one other Sheik, and it appears the war between you and the Middle East continues.
That's right. Everybody knows what happened to the other Sheik. No matter what they say, no matter who he's fighting, I destroyed the Sheik. I destroyed the Iron Sheik. And I'm going to destroy you, Sheik, from Iraq. Because I don't like you. I never did like you. And I'm happy to be here. And there better be somebody out here real soon.
All right, fans, stay with us. We'll find out more about Sergeant Slaughter's demands in just a moment. You're right here live at the Winnipeg Arena. As of yet, we've been unable to find any information about Sergeant Slaughter's demand. Now, wait a minute. Matchmaker Wally Carbo. Wally Carbo, matchmaker right here on Pro Wrestling USA. Wally, I'm certain you're aware of the demands made moments ago by Sergeant Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter, I like your idea of cleaning house. I will tell you right now, if you wanted to get Mr. Saito in the ring, next week, you got him in the ring.
All right, okay.
All right, wrestling fans, you just heard it signed by matchmaker Wally Carbo right here. Next week on Pro Wrestling USA, Sergeant Slaughter to meet Sarge, the man they call Mr. Torture, Mr. Saito.
Well, they call me the Terminator around here, and I'm just this close to starting to make my big dump. I'm going to go out somewhere, dig a big hole, and I'm going to have a big hole there. I'm going to start dropping Saito, the Masked Superstar, and the Sheik all in this big hole. And I'm going to put a big marker on it and call it the Tomb of the Unknown Sheik.
All right, now, Sergeant Slaughter, one thing you've got to remember, actions like we saw moments ago, anytime one of Sheik's contingent is in the ring, you have got to keep a very close eye on one Sheik Adnan El-Casey.
That's right. I'll have my eye on him. Sheik, you step one finger in my way, and I'll bite it right off. I'm Sergeant Slaughter, drill instructor, USA's number one Inspirational Wrestler of 1984. If it's the last breath out of my body, I'm going to kick your can, Saito. I'm going to put you out of wrestling, Sheik. God bless America.
All right, wrestling fans, you just heard it. Next week, Sergeant Slaughter to meet Mr. Saito. In addition, a very, very big announcement for all you great fans in and around the New York area. We'll see you next week right here on Pro Wrestling USA.
Here, that's an order.